Alright guys, today we're out here on Lakeside. We're going to be patrolling down in the main Lakeside city. We're going to be taking Lakewood Ave all the way down into the town. So we have Sam as 1A2, Dean as 1A3, and me as 1A1. I'm going to be your sergeant for today. So make sure we're just doing simple stuff. Make sure you're using your radios and using backup appropriately and all that. If you have any questions, go ahead and say it over the radio, but try to keep radio traffic clear and realistic. If you guys do want to go ahead and play with us, this is private and closed down, kind of. But you can go ahead, join the Steam group, and comment on the discussion that may or may not be linked. Just click the check the description and see if there's anything in there or comment. I'll get back to you, or one of us will. So, yeah. That's about it. You guys want to say anything or ask anything?
One A two
will be running. Squad.
1A2 is bomb squad. If anything happens, kind of that's his backup thing. 1A3 is medical. So if you have any medical issues, then you're gonna be there. 1A3, make sure you have like blood bags and all that kind of shit, right?
Yep.
All right, great. Me 1A3. I'm gonna be sergeant, so I'll have like flashbangs, anything related to breaching, you know, so that's about it. We can go ahead and get started.
I'm gonna quickly grab some extra.
Alright, go for it. 1A1, 10-8.
1A2, same traffic.
1A3 is 10-8.
It's like a fucking maze trying to get up. 1A1's gonna be 10-8, warning given. I'm gonna be in route code 3 to 1A2's position.
10-5.
Copy that.
One and one on scene.
Gotcha.
10-4. Just running a quick diagnosis, we're pretty good for now.
Alright, here we go, I'm gonna inject you some morphine. Might sting a little bit. Might be a little bit numb.
10-4.
What happened here?
What won't you be talking to of you? I see multiples of you in multiple different colors.
Alright, I'll hook you up with some blood, so might feel a little pinch.
I'm gonna check out your vehicle.
Yeah.
Yeah, your vehicle is kind of fucked.
Eh.
Still drives.
It's probably gonna have a heavy pan to one side, I'm guessing.
Wheels aren't damaged, it's just the hull. I don't have any repair kits, so
yeah.
Can't really do too much about it.
May have to get it replaced.
Try driving it around since we don't have any more vehicle. We have one more vehicle back
there. I would do that as soon as I stop seeing what
I'll do
colors.
A final diagnosis.
Yeah, so what happened?
So, there were some goats crossing the road back there, a huge pack of them. I didn't see them because I was coming around the corner. I had to slam on my brakes. I lost control of the back end and just jammed into the tree.
Yeah. Lucky you didn't get killed from that.
I was unconscious for a little bit.
Oh.
You're good
that
to go.
That mayday was the second I regained consciousness, I called that.
Wow.
I was hoping if I didn't regain consciousness, you guys would come looking for me.
Alright. Well,
are you okay now?
Or are you still tripping?
I'm still tripping out.
He's under the effects of morphine. He's a little bit numb, so.
I'm gonna see how badly damaged my vehicle is.
Yeah, it should be fine.
I can take you back to the station if you need help. Good to go. Clear scene.
Yeah, let's go 10-8. 1A1, 1A2, 1A3 are gonna be 10-8.
182 is going to switch vehicles.
10-4, 182, do you need someone to drive you back to the station?
Negative, my vehicle just has a halt pod pulled to the left-hand side.
Stand by, go ahead and leave your vehicle on the side of the road. 183 can take you back to the station.
10-4, let me turn off my lights and everything.
103 copies. 103 to dispatch. We got a stranded vehicle in the middle of the highway here. I'm gonna pull over and check it out.
10-4. One A one's gonna be 10-6 on a vehicle broken down in the middle of the road too. Gonna be on ACDC Ave. Cross street is Kennedy.
Copy that.
One and one's gonna be 10-8, vehicle moved.
Copy that. Sit rep on my scene, and this vehicle is out of service, it's unable to move on its own. There's no driver on the scene, no owner in sight, so this vehicle's stranded.
10-4, I'm gonna come over code 2.
Copy that.
Stand by, I have a vehicle that's swerving around in lanes. He just knocked over a pole. We're gonna be on ACDC Avenue, disregard. We're gonna be crossing ACDC Avenue heading on Kennedy. I'm gonna stand by for secondary to pull him over.
Copy that.
Be advised, subject just passed double yellow lines and he's heading off towards the street. I'm gonna light him up now.
Copy.
He just hit a tree.
Nothing to see here. Military transport.
Sir, get out of your vehicle with your hands up.
This is a military transport. Nothing to see.
Sir, get out of the vehicle now. He advised that the vehicle stopped. Sir.
Copy that.
Out of the vehicle. Don't move. Don't move. Stay right there. Move to your right. 3 steps. Good. Turn around. Be advised, I have him at gunpoint.
10-4.
Subject is in custody. Alright, buddy, can you explain what you were doing back there?
This is a military transport. You have no right to pull me over.
No, you crossed several lanes of traffic, crossed a double yellow, and then drove into a tree.
That driving into a tree was an accident. The sun was in my eyes.
181 to 183 direct. Can you still come on scene?
Copy that. What's your 20?
We're going to be off of Park Avenue, just north of the paintball arena. You'll see us, we're off-road. Alright, sir.
Copy that.
Can you explain what happened exactly? And why back there you're crossing traffic? You crossed several lanes of traffic.
I missed my turn back there, so I had to make a U-turn.
Okay, and this time you said sun was in your eyes when you crossed a double yellow and drove across the lanes of traffic, across the grass, and then into a tree?
We have a military base up here. This is an access route to it, and I'm going up there to pick up supplies.
Alright, can I see any sort of military identification? You're not in uniform right now.
It's in my truck.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and look at it.
Should be in the course back from passenger side.
trunk seat. Can you help me get this ID? Oh wait, I think I got it. No, I do not. Can you go in there and try to get it? Tell me if it's valid. Go ahead and run it. Alright, so you're saying there's a military base up here?
Yep.
Alright, do you mind if I search you?
Go ahead.
Do you have anything that's gonna harm me in any way? Anything pokey or sharp?
Nope. Everything like that's in the truck.
Alright. I mean, you did kind of, cross those lanes of traffic, and that wasn't good at all. Plus, you crashed this vehicle, so... 183, can you come over here? Alright, make sure I'm whispering. He seems like he's not intoxicated or anything, but what happened was I was all the way back there, two traffic lights back.
Yeah.
I was driving forward and I saw him. He made a U-turn, and then I might have been like a block away. The U-turn was like very messed up though, and then he passed the traffic light, and at the traffic light he started swerving to the opposite lane of traffic and then swerving back in. And then about here where those rocks are, where it turns, you can turn right if you're heading north, but if you're heading east, I mean, he swerved across the double yellow and then across all these lanes and then straight on into here, into that tree. And he, you know, even if this is some sort of military whatever establishment he's talking about, he did ignore me for almost two traffic lights.
Do you wanna book him for reckless?
Yeah, well, let's hear his story first. Or what were you saying that he? What's up with him? He's local militia.
Yeah, he isn't. He's not registered with any U.S. National Guard base. He's not registered as a veteran. He's not registered anything with regards to the U.S. government, armed forces. So if he's anything military, he must be militia or private security or anything like that.
All right. I mean, he's not wearing a proper U.S. uniform, so we can go ahead and book him for reckless driving. We'll get that vehicle towed too. Let's just go ahead and talk to him about his military shirt. Alright, sir, are you here?
Yep.
Alright, my partner ran your ID. Do you wanna say what came up?
Yes, so you want to explain to him what we found?
Yeah, just say what you found out.
So we ran your identification through all your records and your history. You did not check out through the U.S. government, through the armed forces, through the National Guard. You're not registered as a National Guard member. You're not registered as a U.S. Army veteran. So we suspect you're either private militia, private security, or any other militia force that is not registered under our database. So,
you want to go talk to one of our fire teams, which is up there on the hill expecting the transport vehicle?
All right. Yeah.
I mean, the issue is if you are, you know, whatever military, you made a U-turn up there, which is legal. I forget exactly where you made it. Then you crossed some lines of traffic, and then you hit this tree. Plus, for about two traffic lights, you did not pull over when I lit you up at about that traffic light back there, and you did not pull over until now.
At no point did you light me up.
We can check the dash cam footage.
Dash cam, my ass!
I turned on my siren and everything. And then, right about...
You know what?
Where those rocks
I'll
are.
I'll tell you who I am, unless you want to go talk to my boss, how about you listen up? Okay?
Okay, what do you have to say?
You have no right to pull this vehicle over.
You have every right, sir. You're endangering the population, and when you disobey traffic laws and you endanger yourself and others, we have the right to stop you, no matter who you are.
So we could book you right now for reckless driving.
Plus impound the vehicle. and they'd have to sort this thing out to get the vehicle back.
You want to go talk to the fire team leader, which is up there? But...
At the moment, currently, he's not really involved with this, but if he wants to intervene and get the vehicle back, he's going to have to go through all the paperwork involved with all the traffic violations.
Yeah, that's... Listen, we can just give him a citation, tell his boss or whatever to go ahead and give him an evaluation, and then they can deal with him from there.
We'll give him the citation for the truck. We'll let the boss know what he's been up to. We'll let him go from military discipline.
Alright.
I'm gonna write up the ticket.
Yeah, are you gonna write it up right now?
Do you want me to?
Yeah, could you? I'm just gonna tell this guy what we're gonna do.
Alright, I got it.
Alright. Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna be writing you a citation for the traffic violations today. Other than that, you're gonna be off clear. If you get your boss down here, or whoever you, would report to, we are gonna tell him what has happened today. And, military will take farther action from there.
Alrighty then.
Alright, sir. We're gonna issue this ticket of $150 for another first several violations of traffic law, as well as reckless driving and criminal endangerment. So here you go. Easier.
Move up.
Alrighty then.
Alright, you're gonna be released, okay?
Okay.
Alright, there you go.
Alright, thank you.
Alright. 21, 23, 10-8. Citation given. Check out your vehicle.
Yeah,
your vehicle is kind of fucked.
Yeah.
Still drives.
It's probably gonna have a heavy pan to one side, I'm guessing.
Wheels aren't damaged, it's just the hull. I don't have any repair kits, so
yeah.
Can't really do too much about it.
May have to get it replaced.
Try driving it around since we don't have any more vehicle. We have one more vehicle back
there. I would do that as soon as I stop seeing the
I'll do
colors.
A final diagnosis.
Yeah, so what happened?
So, there were some goats crossing the road back there, a huge pack of them. I didn't see them because I was coming around the corner. I had to slam on my brakes. I lost control of the back end and just jammed into the tree.
Yeah, lucky you didn't get killed from that.
I was unconscious for a little bit.
Oh,
you're good to go.
That mayday was the second I regained consciousness, I called that.
Wow.
I was hoping if I didn't regain consciousness, you guys would come looking for me.
Alright, well,
are you okay now,
or are you still tripping?
I'm still tripping out.
He's under the effects of morphine, he's a little bit numb, so...
I'm gonna see how badly damaged my vehicle is.
Yeah, it should be fine.
I can take you back to the station if you need help. Good to go. Clear scene.
Yeah, let's go 10-8. 181, 182, 183 are gonna be 10-8.
One A two is gonna switch vehicle. 10-4, 182.
Do you need someone to drive you back to the station?
Negative. My vehicle just has a halt pod pulled to the left-hand side.
Standby. Go ahead and leave your vehicle on the side of the road. 183 can take you back to the station.
Tempo, let me turn off my lights and everything.
103 copies. 103 to dispatch. We got a stranded vehicle in the middle of the highway here. I'm gonna pull over and check it out.
10-4. 1A1's gonna be 10-6 on a vehicle broken down in the middle of the road too. Gonna be on Ace Road across the double yellow, and then across all these lanes, and then straight on into here, into that tree. And you know, even if this is some sort of military whatever establishment he's talking about, he did ignore me for almost two traffic lights.
Wanna book him for reckless?
Yeah, let's hear his story first. Or what were you saying that he? What's up with him? He's local militia.
Yeah, he doesn't. He's not registered with any U.S. National Guard base. He's not registered as a veteran. He's not registered anything with regards to the U.S. government, armed forces. So if he's anything military, he must be militia or private security or anything like that.
All right. I mean, he's not wearing a proper U.S. uniform, so we can go ahead and book him for reckless driving. We'll get that vehicle towed too. Let's just go ahead and talk to him about his military shit. Alright, sir, are you here?
Yep.
Alright, my partner ran your ID. Do you wanna say what came up?
Yes, so you want to explain to him what we found?
Yeah, just say what you found out.
So we ran your identification through all your records and your history. You did not check out through the U.S. government, through the armed forces, through the National Guard. You're not registered as a National Guard member. You're not registered as a U.S. Army veteran. So we suspect you're either private militia, private security, or any other militia force that is not registered under our database. So,
you want to go talk to one of our fire teams, which is up there on the hill expecting this transport vehicle?
All right. Yeah.
I mean, the issue is if you are, you know, whatever military, you made a U-turn up there, which is legal. I forget exactly where you made it. Then you crossed some lines of traffic, and then you hit this tree. Plus, for about two traffic lights, you did not pull over when I lit you up at about that traffic light back there, and you did not pull over until now.
At no point did you light me up.
We can check the dash cam footage.
Dash cam, my ass!
I turned on my siren and everything. And then, right about,
you know what?
Where those rocks
I'll
are.
I'll tell you who I am, unless you want to go talk to my boss, how about you listen up? Okay?
Okay, what do you have to say?
You have no right to pull this vehicle over.
CDC Ave, Cross Street is Kennedy.
Copy that.
One in one's gonna be 10-8, vehicle moved.
Sit rep on my scene, and this vehicle is out of service. It's unable to move on its own. There's no driver on the scene, no owner in sight, so this vehicle's stranded.
10-4, I'm gonna come over code 2.
Copy that.
Stand by. I have a vehicle that's swerving around in lanes. You just knocked over a pole. We're gonna be on ACDC Avenue. Disregard. We're gonna be crossing ACDC Avenue, heading on Kennedy. I'm gonna stand by for secondary to pull him over.
Copy that.
Be advised, subject just passed double yellow lines, and he's heading off towards the street. I'm gonna light him up now.
Copy.
He just hit a tree.
Nothing to see here. Military transport.
Sir, get out of your vehicle with your hands up.
This is a military transport. Nothing to see.
Sir, get out of the vehicle now. He advised that the vehicle stopped. Sir.
Copy that.
Out of the vehicle. Don't move. Don't move. Stay right there. Move to your right. 3 steps. Good. Turn around. Be advised, I have him at gunpoint.
10-4.
Subject is in custody. Alright, buddy, can you explain what you were doing back there?
This is a military transport. You have no right to pull me over.
No, you crossed several lanes of traffic, crossed the double yellow, and then drove into a tree.
The driving into a tree was an accident. The sun was in my eyes.
181 to 183 direct. Can you still come on scene?
Copy that. What's your 20?
We're going to be off of Park Avenue, just north of the paintball arena. You'll see us. We're off-road. Alright, sir.
Copy that.
Can you explain what happened exactly and why back there you're crossing traffic? You crossed several lanes of traffic.
I missed my turn back there, so I had to make a U-turn.
Okay. And this time you said sun was in your eyes when you crossed a double yellow and drove across the lanes of traffic, across the grass, and then into a tree?
We have a military base up here. This is an access route to it, and I'm going up there to pick up supplies.
Alright, can I see any sort of military identification? You're not in uniform right now.
It's in my truck.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and look at it.
Should be in the course back from passenger side.
Sorry, wrong seat. Can you help me get this ID? Oh wait, I think I got it. No, I do not. Can you go in there and try to get it? Tell me if it's valid. Go ahead and run it. Alright, so you're saying there's a military base up here?
Yep.
Alright, do you mind if I search you?
Go ahead.
Do you have anything that's gonna harm me in any way? Anything pokey or sharp?
Nope. Everything like that in the truck.
Alright. I mean, you did kind of, cross those lanes of traffic, and that wasn't good at all. Plus, you crashed this vehicle, so. 183, can you come over here? Alright, make sure I'm whispering. He seems like he's not intoxicated or anything, but what happened was I was all the way back there, 2 traffic lights back.
Yeah.
I was driving forward and I saw him. He made a U-turn, and then I might have been like a block away. The U-turn was like very messed up though, and then he passed the traffic light, and at the traffic light he started swerving to the opposite lane of traffic and then swerving back in. And then about here where those rocks are, where it turns, you can turn right if you're heading north. Wait, if you're heading east, I mean. He swerved. All right, guys, today we're out here on Lakeside. We're gonna be patrolling down in the main Lakeside city. We're gonna be taking Lakewood Ave all the way down into the town. So we have Sam as 1A2, Dean as 1A3, and me as 1A1. I'm going to be your sergeant for today. So make sure we're just doing simple stuff. Make sure you're using your radios and using backup appropriately and all that. If you have any questions, go ahead and say it over the radio, but try to keep radio traffic clear and realistic. If you guys do want to go ahead and play with us, this is private and closed down, kind of. But you can go ahead, join the Steam group, and comment on the discussion that may or may not be linked. Just click the check the description and see if there's anything in there or comment. I'll get back to you, or one of us will. So, yeah, that's about it. You guys want to say anything or ask anything?
No, all good.
182 will be running, Bomb Squad.
182 is Bomb Squad. If anything happens, kind of that's his backup thing. 183 is medical, so if you have any medical issues, then you're going to be there.
Yep.
183, make sure you have, like, blood bags and all that kind of shit, right?
Yep.
All right, great. Me, 183, I'm going to be sergeant, so I'll have, like, flashbangs, anything related to breaching. You know, so that's about it. We can go ahead
and
get started.
Grab some extra.
All right, go for it. 181, 10-8.
182, same traffic.
103 is 10-8.
It's like a fucking maze trying to get up. 181's gonna be 10-8. Warning given. I'm gonna be in route code 3 to 182's position.
10-5.
Copy that.
Gotcha.
10-4. Just running a quick diagnosis, we're pretty good for now.
Alright, here we go, I'm gonna inject you some morphine. Might sting a little bit. Might be a little bit numb.
10-4. What happened here?
What one should I be talking to of you? I see multiples of you in multiple different colors.
Alright, I'll hook you up with some blood, so I might feel a little pinch.